No sooner had Treasurers started to implement strategies at the beginning of 2020 than the economic outlook changed dramatically. The COVID-19 pandemic spread across the globe at extraordinary pace, leading Treasurers to change their plans. Welcome to this Deutsche Bank discussion in association with EuroFinance, part of the Economist Group. I'm joined today by Ole Matthiessen, Global Head of Cash Management at Deutsche Bank, to discuss the findings of an Economist Intelligence Unit report supported by Deutsche Bank, where we look at the resilient Treasury and its priorities for the future. Thank you for joining me, Ole.
Thanks, Emily, for having me here.
So the aim of the survey was to understand the forces that will shape and define the Treasury function over the coming decade. But, you know, what a time to run a survey in the middle of a pandemic. Ole, can you tell me a little bit about the immediate impact on the corporate treasury function?
In the middle of the pandemic, it was really two things. It's on the one hand, really being focusing on the liquidity. And the liquidity in two sense, basically making sure that the forecasting of liquidity will actually, you know, go from longer, more strategic measures back to the imminent and very short-term measures. And then secondly, also in terms of making sure that the liquidity stays afloat within a large organization that, you know, conducts business on a worldwide basis. The largest three risk factors mentioned by the respondents had all ties to the disease itself. So when you think about the pandemic risk mentioned by more than 43% of the respondents, when you think about the whole economic and growth impact, and also the inflationary and deflationary, you know, potential impact. With lots of excess liquidity, both because we had a prosperous economy over the last decade, but also because, you know, many corporates started to really hoard liquidity for risk measures, shifting the focus from yield optimization to a very diversified approach has been one of the key trends that became quite clear and that many of the treasurers have answered.
Which regulatory changes have had the biggest impact on the treasury function in 2020?
Yeah, the IBOR regulation was mentioned, and I think had been a very, very big migration effort also, both on the bank side, but also on the corporations.
Which business model disruptions have had the biggest impact on corporate treasury?
For corporations, the ability to really have an omni-channel approach where you have in-store, e-commerce, and also mobile, you know, functionalities, like all work in tandem and all making sure they generate the same data that you can use and really understand your client has been a big focus. When you think about digitizing, having more data in-house, the cyber risk obviously is enhanced, and it's also something that treasurers have mentioned as part of the survey.
What's your view on the bank's role in supporting corporate treasurers as companies become more digital, both in terms of services but also in terms of data?
It shouldn't be the case that clients need to call us 20,000 times a year to really understand where their cash lies and whether a payment has gone through or not. That should all be digitized. It's really about ensuring that we can help our clients in their business model transformation. I believe that in the future, the quality of relationship will clearly be much more important than the quantity. Therefore, having a small number of banks, top quality relationships, and really having a multi-bank approach when it comes to those global and overall topics will remain a focus area. That's where we want to play as banks. That's where we want to play as Deutsche Bank.
Ole, thank you very much for joining me.
Thanks, Emily, for having me here.